And if you go to the Philippines, what's happening now in the Philippines is that every family has a drug problem, including my family. If you know why I am here right now, I came from very far. I live in Germany, but I traveled all the way here to voice my words, to voice what is really happening in the Philippines. This is not just a human rights issue. Ms. Calamard is right, this is also a public issue. And now my point is that you need to look at the other side of the story. I appreciate the effort of the journalist. It was well presented. However, the real scenario, mentioning that 7,000 were killed with this drug problem or this war on drugs, it is not. When you check on the details, when you do, I urge all of you to do your research, because this 7,000 killings is not just all about drugs. These are all the murders happening since the president came into power. And I tell you, the last administration, this extrajudicial killings has been happening. Yes. And it is not just the time of the president. Yes. The president is so angry about the drug problem because it is so huge and you cannot imagine it. You see the people, the very poor people. I have a friend, 12-year-old. 12-year-old is using drugs. That's how difficult human rights. I urge you, there, during the term of the president, since he came to power in July, there are 1,900,000 drug surrenders. The United Nations, we urge all of you to help us with this problem. You come to us, help us with this health problem. Build rehabilitation centers for these people. You see all those accused of drugs in the prison. It is catastrophic. If you're concerned about people, you go to the Philippines and help us build rehabilitation centers and stop meddling with the political affairs of the Philippines, because the case is in court and you need to respect the law of the Philippines. Thank you.
Thank you, madam.